So my name is Yoann Lemoine. I'm French. I'm also known as Woodkid, which is my musician name. But I'm also a filmmaker, mainly a filmmaker. And then I started to introduce my musical background in my work 5 years ago. And now I have a whole thing happening about music. So I'm trying to be a musician.
That I'm supposed to say. My skin swelling fireflies. Agnes has surrounded Baltimore Bay. Why don't you open your blue eyes? Are they things that water can't wash away?
Today I've seen like the most crafted artisans I've never seen. So precise. It's like, I wish one day I can reach that level of precision in my work. I would probably need to be like 500 years old. But I mean, it's interesting. One thing that I thought was fascinating is when you see the early processes of working on the wood, or working on the iron, putting them together, there's something extremely violent at the early process of making a piano, of bending the wood, of stretching it together, melting it, engineering it. And then the more you go into the detail, the more precise it gets to the level of a finger, to the level of an eye. And there's something in the way I work that's kind of similar. When I make a song, I like to think of it as a sculpture, which is I have a big block of material that I carve in a very rough way, and then I will slowly carve every detail and try to be more and more precise about the intonation of a chord, intonation of a vocal element, of a string element, the reverb on this. But the beginning is just me waking up and like blah, and like slowly like shaping things together from just a raw material that is me waking up in the morning and probably being hungover or something, and just like trying to get a bit civilized about it. There's something like that. It was very brutal to see this guy like shaping the wood and like screwing it in. It's you never for something that delicate. It's very interesting. What is very humbling about the process of making a piano here is the sum of knowledge that is required to make a grand here. What is very inspiring here is pretty much all the science that is being injected in the making of a piano is pre-technology era, is science that has been brought by intuition, by listening, by trying to understanding the unknown that faceted this with time, this shape, this structure that is so complex and so strange when you look at it. It asks a lot of questioning, and I love that. I love to question myself a lot on the things that I hear and the things that I see. When I see light bouncing on a wall, I'm trying to understand why a certain phenomenon is happening. When I hear a sound, when I hear the distortion of a sound, when I hear the quality of a sound, I'm trying to understand why it's creating that emotion, why it's that perfect in my own way. And then in the process of learning, then you achieve eventually the process of remaking, of recreating, of making things your own. So it's very interesting. It's very interesting that to see that this is the sum of hundreds and hundreds of years of experimentation, of perfecting, of, I mean, it's incredible. What's very interesting is that nobody can know how complex it is, even the people that work on it, on some parts of it. So there's like a mystery to the other parts of it, and it's the sum of all this that makes the magic of it. It's a whole orchestra in there. My house is also my studio, so I work at my place. It's very important for me because I need a form of confidence and warmth around me when I work. I always work most of the time from a harmonic sequence, whether it be a simple sequence or a sequence of chords is more complicated. It's always a starting point on which I can lay down the melodies. So the instrument is the most obvious for me is the piano. I need a piano in my house. And also it is also a social dimension to it. Having an instrument like that is when you have friends that come and you play, it creates a dynamic. I have a lot of obviously musician friends. And then we make dinners, and then it always ends up around the piano. It's just it's like a magnet in the house. It's obviously a big piano, so it's big in the house. I have a tendency to like sounds in general that are extremely wooden and warm, that have a sense of depth, and that's what you get with a very good piano. You get harmonics that are equally very grounded, but that don't suffer when you go high, that still are very defined and loud and sharp. Yes, I mean, there's, with a piano in production, there's so much you can do. It's not just about playing the piano, like, this, I mean, there's so much you can create with this. I just worked recently a lot with Sonlux on preparing pianos in a ways that we would create a whole bank of instruments, of sounds, of things that we could assemble, of rhythms, of bowing the strings. There's so much that we do just with this instrument that is more than just like percussive harmonic elements. That with a piano, I could make a whole album with just a piano, I'm sure. And even like an album that doesn't sound like a piano album. I think most of my work has been about questioning the organic versus the digital world. Questioning the beauty of nature, of how sound works in a space like that. Extremely controlled, but at the same time almost divine, because it's the science of sound that's at its best. And when you sample it, there's a fakeness to it that is so interesting for me. It's a dialogue that's interesting to put in music. It's a real questioning of our times. And obviously, I mainly started doing music by working on computers and using digital pianos and digital instruments. But one thing that I've always been extremely uncomfortable with is when technology is trying to replace reality, but obviously doesn't do it as well as hundreds of years of craft of. So I would be interested in the digital sound of an orchestra, the digital sound of a piano even. But if it's used as is, if it's not a pretension to replace the beautiful qualities of a real piano, obviously when you play two notes together, there's a science of harmonics that creates a sound that is unique because these two notes are being played together. If I play a third, a fourth, a fifth note with it, there's a science of harmony that gets multiplication of parameters that make it even more complex and divine almost, which is what Steinway and this craft has been managed to capture. I don't consider technology as something that erases tradition, erases knowledge, erases the past when it's used properly, when it's an addition. It's something that, how am I going to be able to sonorize this in a way that has been never heard before? To me, that's good technology because it's a sum of things. It's a sum of tradition, of the perfection of a sound, plus a way of hearing it in a recording that has never been heard before. To me, that's the way I want to apprehend technology and apprehend progress. It's only when it's relying on tradition, relying on on craft, because you get better by adding, by summing things, not by ignoring the past or deleting it. To me, that's super super important. When you see how people work on these pianos, and you see this, the it's very hard to understand it. Every piece of the piano, from almost a screw to how a piece is varnished or how a string is attached, and every single element is one person that has that is working on hundreds of years of craft on that specific level. It exists, I think, a lot of ways around to make that easier, but because it's not easy, because it's so complex, it makes it so special. I think it's all about balance. It's all about the implication that it asks for the player too. There's pianos that ask to be played. It's not just easy pianos. It's pianos that ask you to enter it. I think it's a very unique instrument. Steinways are the best pianos. There's no, I mean, it's not even like a point of view. It's what it is.
I'll let you sink in Baltimore Bay. I drown myself deep in disgrace.